Namaskar students, we will be continuing with our chapter on collection of data. In a previous class, we have been discussing about the sampling errors and the non-sampling errors. And in this class, we will be discussing about non-response errors and we will move forward with the chapter. Now, non-response errors means, say, suppose a particular the sample is being taken from the population, like a certain unit is being included in the sample, but the interviewer is unable to contact that person who is listed in the sample. So, or the sample refuses to respond to the interviewer, then it is called non-response error. So, you are not getting any response from the unit which is included in the sample. And sample bias means you have purposely not included certain samples who are the target population, you have not included them in the sample. So that is called sample bias. Next is Census of India and NSSO. So there are, you know, certain agencies, both you have it at the national level and you also have it at the state level, who are actually collecting data, processing data and tabulating the statistical data. Now some of the major agencies, we can name them as Census of India, then National Sample Survey Organization, that is NSSO, then Central Statistical Organization, CSO, Registrar General of India, Directorate General of Commercial Intelligence and Statistics, Labor Bureau, etc. So these are the different kind of agencies who are actually handling the data, collecting it, processing it, tabulating it and interpreting it. Now the Census of India is the most, you know, continuous and demographic record of the population it keeps. It helps to you to know about the population, such as the size of the population, where is the density of the population more, what is the sex ratio, that is how many males and how many females are there, then the literacy rate, migration, rural urban distribution, etc. So if you want to know all this, you have to be based on the census collected data. Now again, this NSSO, that is the National Sample Survey Organization, was established by the government so that it could conduct nationwide surveys on socio-economic issues. Now it also does continuous surveys on the socio-economic conditions of the people, like it provides you periodic estimates about the this literacy, then it will provide about the school enrollment, then utilization of educational services, employment, unemployment, manufacturing sector, service sector, what is the employment distribution. So all these are provided in the by the NSSO. So there are different agencies who look into the different. So this way, you know, NSSO will undertake the field work of annual survey for industries, the crops grown, collects rural and urban retail prices for complication. So these are all being determined by NSSO. So here, see, we find that for all economic interpretations or demographic interpretation, collection of data, sampling is very important so that we could understand what problems we are facing and how we can come out of those problems. So solutions to those problems, so statistical tools or this data interpretation is very important. And there might be errors while we are doing collecting of the data is done. So and how we can overcome those errors that are happening. So this is all what we have in this chapter. So we have come to the end of this chapter, and just go through it, and if you have any doubts, please get it clarified. Om Namah Shivaya.